Welcome back to our NEPA Top Model Casting Call Special. I'm Erin Dugan, and we've been holding auditions like this for the past 3 years. And one of the questions we're asked all the time is, has anybody from this tryout ever made it onto the big show? And the answer is yes.
19-year-old Brittany auditioned at the Shops at Montage in July of 2010. Her home is Beach Creek, PA, a very small town near Lock Haven. The 5'10 and a half inch college student's audition stood out in Scranton, and now Brittany is one of the 14 contestants on the new season of America's Next Top Model.
Well, I'm joined now by Brittany. Brittany, we just got to see you on the season premiere of America's Next Top Model. And you tried out at our tryouts last year at the Shops at Montage. What is this like for you now being here?
It's absolutely insane to be back in the area and the whole process of it, people finding out who I am now. And it's really overwhelming having auditioned in Scranton and making it the whole way into the top 14 of the house. Like, it's a crazy experience being from such a small town, so.
And the question probably everybody wants to know is, what was Tyra like? What was it like meeting her?
It was amazing meeting Tyra for the first time. We were doing casting week and she walked through the doors and we were all screaming, and she was really as beautiful as she is whenever you see her on TV or in the magazines. And so it was really just an incredible moment.
And what's your modeling dream? Where do you see yourself?
Hopefully I see myself on the Marc Jacobs runway. That would be what I would want to do, because I just, like, Marc Jacobs is my favorite designer as an artist. Like, he's just a really great person, and I would love to work with him and do runway work, so.
And why should people tune in to see you on our show this year?
People should definitely tune in to Cycle 16 to see me, because, you know, I'm representing the CW here in Wilkes-Barre, Scranton, and I'm a small-town girl, and who doesn't want to watch a small-town girl kick butt on top of them?
Perfectly said, and we can't wait to watch you this season, and thank you so much for stopping by to talk with
us. Yeah, thanks for having me. It was great meeting you.
So you can get your big break at a local casting call just like this. And Brittany is living proof. Let's send it back over to AJ from 97BHG, who's standing by with some more ladies who are hoping to be in Brittany's Manolo Blahniks in the next cycle of America's Next Top Model.
This is Cynthia from Wilkes-Barre. Cynthia, how old are you?
19.
19. Now, what inspired you to want to try out today for the casting call?
I've been through a lot in my life, and just people saying certain things aren't possible, and just basically I want to prove to them that anything is possible, and not just myself, maybe I can help other girls too, because the points that I've been at was just like everyone just wants to bring you down, and I just want to go above and beyond and prove to myself and everyone that I can do whatever I want to do and be what I want to be.
So did your friends and family totally support you in this?
My friends are very supportive, yeah. I don't really have a close-knit family, but I mean, my friends are always supportive and always have been, so.
The best of luck.
Thank you.
And Jenny actually traveled from afar today. How far did you travel?
Well, I actually came from Long Island, New York, so it's about 3 hours drive, and after this I'm going home, which is in Maryland, so it's another 5 hour drive.
Wow, what time did you get here today?
I got here at 12:30.
12:30, okay, yes. So you didn't have that much of a wait in line.
No, I didn't. I actually got really lucky, so it was good.
Well, very, very good. What do you think you possess that could make you America's Next Top Model?
Wow, I have a lot of confidence in myself. My family and my friends have told me that I'm, you know, gorgeous and I can, you know, do what I want to do. And so pretty much like the support that, you know, I get from my friends and family, you know, from, you know, just everybody, it pretty much drives me to come up here and work my ass off and do what I want to do.
Well, I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you.
Let's welcome Sabrina from Plymouth to the show. Sabrina, you're a big fan of the show,
yes,
aren't you?
Very much so,
You've
yes.
You've been watching it for years.
Yes, I have.
If you had to compare yourself and your personality to one of the other models from the show, who would it be?
Well, I'm definitely outgoing, and I'm very fun and spontaneous, and I'm very silly at times, so.
So who would you compare that with from the show?
Not sure, but probably Tyra.
Okay.
Yeah, she's silly sometimes and random.
All right, very good.
Yeah.
Well, the best of luck.
Thank you.
This is Tasha from Kingston. Tasha, have you ever done anything like this before?
Yeah, I did this once before.
Okay.
And it was a nice experience. This experience is a little different, a little better. It's nice.
Are you nervous?
Yeah.
Were you nervous when you were doing your audition?
Very. It was like so much pressure on me. I felt like I had so much dependent on me.
What do you think the hardest part of the audition process really is?
Being in the open with everybody, being able to see you and hear everything you're saying and actually watching your audition. I think that's hard.
But you made through it, right?
Yeah.
Well, the best of luck to you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And we're here with Daphne. She goes to school in Elmira, New York. Now, Daphne, while you were waiting in line, mm-hmm. did you become friendly with any of the girls?
Yeah, I actually had one of my friends that came with me. So it has a very bubbly personality okay. as well. So me and her were just kind of striking a conversation with the girls in line.
Now, do you think if you made it to the big competition that being friendly with the girls is a good thing or it could be a bad thing?
A good thing if you're on good terms with people, there's less drama, just become friends. I'm not against, like, I don't want to isolate myself in any way, so.
Well, the best of luck.
Thank you.
Thank you. Sarah from Scranton, welcome to the show.
Hey.
Now, tell us about your personality. Are you an outgoing person? Are you a little bit shy? Was this a little bit awkward for you today?
Well, yeah, it's nerve-wracking, mm-hmm. but you never know what you're going to step into, and there's a lot of really pretty girls here, and, you know, I'm a little different because I have the tattoos. I am outgoing once you get to know me. I am laid back at first because I try to just watch and listen and see what's right. going on.
So something like this today, it's really stepping out of your normal comfort zone.
Yeah, a little bit. I'm trying to, you know, relax, take it all in.
Well, the best of luck with your with the big competition.
Thanks.
You're welcome. Love kick starts again. This is Nicole from Spring Creek. Nicole, what inspired you to audition for the casting call today?
Well, I mean, this is something that I've wanted to do for a long time. When I was growing up, I wasn't much to look at. I was short and awkward and chubby, and I was an outcast. I really want to do this. It's something that inspires me. It's something that I want to do to inspire other girls. To let them know that they're better than what they grew up with. They're better than what other people thought they were.
Well, you are a great inspiration to a lot of girls watching the show right now.
Thank you.
Thank you. This is Alicia from 44. Alicia, how old are you?
18.
18.
Yes.
And are you in high school, in college?
College, University of Scranton.
And what are you studying?
Biology, pre-med.
Do a lot of your friends at school know you're doing this today?
Yes, they were very excited for me to be here.
Yeah, what'd they think when you told them you wanted to audition?
They said that I would definitely make it. Hopefully it comes true. Okay.
What'd you think of the competition outside when you were waiting in line? Were you scoping out the other girls?
There's a lot of other tall, very pretty girls, I think, that are very eligible for the position as an America's Next Top Model.
Well, the best of luck to you.
Thank you.
We're here with Christina from Berwick. Christina, tell us why you think you could be America's Next Top Model.
I'm different, I'm unique, and I'm independent. And I like to have fun, but I could be serious at the same time. And I think that's going to bring something new to America's Next Top Model.
And what do you like to do in your spare time?
I like to draw and take pictures and paint and pretty much anything artsy. And I like to spend time with my friends.
So very artistic, very creative.
Mm-hmm.
Well, good luck with the competition.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And we're chatting with Catherine. She's from Long Island, New York. Welcome yes. to the show.
Thank you.
Have you ever done anything like this before?
I haven't.
No? What'd you think of today as you pulled up for the competition?
I was pretty nervous. I wasn't nervous last night, but as I pulled up, I was getting anxious and nervous.
Is this what you expected?
No. I don't know what I expected, but this isn't it.
Okay. Well, the best of luck.
Thank you.
And Sabrina in Moscow is hoping to be America's Next Top Model. Sabrina, what qualities do you possess you think would make you a great candidate to be America's Next Top Model?
Well, I'm really outgoing. I get along with everyone fairly easily. I'm really nice to everyone. I don't know. Be really creative with everything.
What feature do you think is your best?
Probably my legs, because they're
legs?
Really long.
Yeah. How tall are you?
5'9".
Wow, 5'9". What else would you say makes you a great candidate for America's Next Top Model?
I don't really know. Just try my hardest.
All right, very good. Great outgoing personality.
Yeah.
All right, the best of luck.
Thank you.
Hey everybody, stay tuned. We're here at the Shops at Montage, our big special. We've got a lot more to come.